Hello everyone, in this video we will keep on building on the previous version of the Lisp interpreter, and more specifically we will separate the JavaScript part from the Lisp part. Okay, so let's start from the previous version. Let's save this Lisp 3. Okay, what I want to do is moving this code in a separate file. So let's remove from this file and into lisp.lisp. This is where I want to put the Lisp code. Okay. Now, how to implement this? This is Node.js, so it's very simple to read the file. So var text equal require file system. FS file read sync list.list lisp utf8 as encoding. Let's create also the source stream, and now I will make a loop, and basically I start by skipping space. I check if I got to the end of the string. So if source current, if it's not source current, we just break out of the loop. Otherwise, we evaluate the result of calling a read on our source, and the evaluation is done in the global environment F0. Okay. That's it. And this should work as before. There is one difference. I'm just calling evaluate. I'm not writing the output of the evaluation. And I will change this so that there is a new primitive or print that just given. Anything we call console log x. Okay, now write it. Okay, let me change fibo in print fibo. Oh, let's take advantage of some using so fibo 10 fibo 10. Okay, let's test it. Okay, symnol. Okay, that's a typo. File sync is read file sync. And finally, we got our program working in a separate file. I also want to get rid of the definition of the standard library inside the JavaScript part. I want to move this definition to the Lisp part. And to do this, I just define one function in the JavaScript part. It is called JS. And that simply calls eval x. Eval is here the JavaScript evaluation. Now I can define the standard my library here, rewriting set q plus js of xy arrow x plus y. Addition, subtraction, and less than comparison. And comparison, and I also need to print JS okay. I don't need the wrapping problem because I already have a loop in the program. So now it should work as before. Okay, but now we got the standard library defined here. And let's extend this library a bit. So with the multiplication and division. Let's have other comparison, like less than or equal, greater than, greater than or equal, equal, and not equal. So greater than or equal, greater than or equal, equal, and not equal. And finally, IO. Maybe I also want to be able to add comments. So let's say basic math comparison IO test program. Okay, but the reader is actually not able right now to handle comments. What I want to do is that when finding a semicolon, I want to skip till the end of the line. And I think a good place to do this is in the space skipping function. So let's change this to a loop. So after skipping spaces, if sCurrent is a semicolon, then we make another loop while sCurrent is not line as next. If it's not a semicolon, we break out of this loop. So now we can also handle comments. Anywhere a space is permitted, then we can also put a comment from a semicolon to the end of the line. Or no more comments, because they are removed in a loop. So this should also work. Okay. And this is all for this small video. Thank you for watching and see you next time.